Hi there, in this video we are going to see how you can create some certificates in Moodle in order for each of your students who pass your classes to have his own certificate. So this is possible thanks to a plugin which is named Custom Certificate that you can install in Moodle directly. It doesn't cost anything. I'm not gonna explain how you can design, in fact, or at least how to make a beautiful design of your certificate, because that has been the subject of another video that I published about how to design a certificate in Inkscape. So I'm not gonna explain that out, but I will explain how you can use this plugin in order to automate the creation of the different certificate with the custom first name, family name, and so on and so forth. So of course, the first thing that you need to have is the plugin. So you just go within site administration, and then you upload the plugin that you just downloaded over here. Okay, once you do so, you will have here under plugins the possibility to use the custom certificate, right? The one that you can see here, you have some different settings. The one that you would be mostly interested about in order to begin is the manage template one. So you click over here and manage template, and here you have the possibility to create as many templates as you want. This is very useful because when you create several templates, you can of course assign different templates to different courses. So it means that each of them can have a different design. So here in my case, I created one template, so I can click over here, you will see the full thing. So here are the basic settings. So you can define, of course, the width and the height of your certificate to define the margin. And then this is where all the magic's happening. You can define what are all the different elements that you would like to add. So you can, of course, add the first name, family name, and all those data will be automatically fulfilled. So I'm just going to go back on Manage Template because I already created one. And as you can see over here, I added the background image, which in my case is the one that I created in Inkscape, and then I added the date, the course name, and student name. And in fact, you can reposition all the elements, and this is what I did. So I uploaded, in fact, as a background, the image that I did in Inkscape, and then this one is a variable, right? This one is the first name, or at least the student name of the student, so it's managed dynamically. This is the course name, so in fact, all those elements can just be moved like this on the certificate. And here I added the date as well, which is a dynamic. So this is all possible because I selected all those different elements down below, and I decided to reposition them on the template. So that's it, in fact, for this plugin. Once you create, of course, you save your changes. And when you do so, then when you create one given class, so in my case, I'm gonna go on the site home over here. And I'm gonna go on emailing just to let you know that by default the plugin does not support all fonts. So probably what you will have to do is actually you will have to download your own font over here, and you will have to use a service such as this one in order to convert your font from TTF to TCP PDF. You will get three files, and those three files, you need to upload them on the server at this specific location, right? At var://moodle/lib/tcp/pdf/fonts, and this is where, in fact, the plugin is looking at the different fonts. So if I go for cd/var, okay, HTML, Moodle, TCP, lib, tcp pdf, and fonts, okay, and I look over here, you will see, in fact, all the different fonts which are by default supported by the plugin. And if you would like to add your own font, you will have actually to upload them on your server if you would like the certificate to be able to recognize them, because it doesn't recognize the font by default of Moodle. You need to create specific fonts which are TCP PDF fonts to be supported and included within the certificate. So once you do so, okay, and that you created the certificate, in fact, you add the certificate as an activity. So when you click here on add an activity, you will see this given name which appear, which is custom certificate. And when you add your custom certificate, it's asking you for the name that you would like to put within it, I mean the content. So this is what I did over here. And then of course you can set the settings accordingly. So here in your case, you will probably say, okay, I want this certificate to be displayed when a specific grade has been achieved. Here you are selecting which template you would like to make it available. So here, as you can see, if I go back on my certificate of achievement and that I click on view the certificate, I will get the certificate for me. Okay, so it will look like this. And then your student is happy because he gets or she gets exactly what he or she wanted. Okay. And that's it for everything that I wanted to show you. So thanks to the custom certificate plugin, you can really create the certificate that you want. So we probably use a software such as Inkscape in order to have a beautiful design. Then you will use the settings of custom certificate in order to add dynamically the different variable. Then you will create an activity, and through the activity you will define what are the conditions in order for the certificate to be available, and then your students can download their own certificate. And that's it for today. So please have a look at this given plugin, download it, install it, and try to create your own certificate for your attendees. Once more, thanks for watching this video, and do not hesitate to create your own video and share them on social networks.